pollination. You also studied that. So before, it means male gametes are present in the pollen grain. Okay. So next, female gamete is present in the embryo sac. Egg cell is present in the embryo sac. First process of fertilization. So both are brought. Okay. For the process of fertilization, both are brought together for the fission of gametes. Generally, male gamete and egg cell both are non-monogamous. But how they are reached to them? So how they are brought together? It means one objective is okay. So helped for the fission of gametes. So in plant, this object is known as pollination. Okay, pollination is required for the fission of non-motile male and female gametes. So what is the definition of the pollination? Transfer of pollen grain from the anther to the stigma of the pistil. Okay? In a flower. So that is known as the pollination. For example, it is a stamen. It is known as a pistil. Okay? Transfer of pollen grain. So these are the pollen grain. Pollen grain reached to the stigma of pistil. So this one is a pistil. Transfer of pollen grain from anther reached to stigma of pistil. Stigma of pistil. So that is known as the pollination process. Okay. So in that pollination, so that is known as the pollination process. So generally, pollination is required. So in plants for fertilization because they are non-motile, right? But so these pollen grains are carried by the pollen tube. So they are known as the generally these are the agents. Okay. So after that, by the source of pollen, pollination is spreaded. First one is the autogamy or self-pollination. Second one is the gametogamy. Third one is the xenogamy. So this, what is the first one? Self-pollination. Okay, that is known as the autogamy or self-pollination. So what are the character of the autogamy and self-pollination? For example, in a flower, mostly hermaphrodite flowers. Hermaphrodite means bisexual flowers. Autogamy is occur. Self-pollination is occur. How it is there? For example, it is known as a pistil. So these are the stamens. These are the stamens. It means when the pistil and stamens are arranged closely, okay, both are arranged closely, so easily pollen grains are, okay, falls on the stigma of the same flower. So that is known as the autogamy. Okay, transfer of pollen grain from the anther reach to stigma of same flower. So that is known as the autogamy. Okay, so that is known as the autogamy. It means almost in all plants autogamy is not occur. Okay, so only in some plants autogamy is occur. So it means if the stamens are well exposed, okay, so next one, if both stigma and also stamens both are comes to the mature condition at the same time, then autogamy occur. But in all flowers, so pollen receptive, it means pollen release and pollen receptive, it means mature stigma, it means in all flowers stamens and stigma are not come to that mature condition at the same time. So both are come to that mature condition at the different times. What are the? If stamens and pistils, so both are not comes to the mature condition at the same time. If both are come to that mature condition at the same time, so autogamy is possible. When if dichogamy means so pollen is still, so for example it means pollen release and stigma receptive, okay, both are not come to that mature condition at the same time, so self pollination is not occur, right? In some plants, so in some plants, so flowers are always open, they are exposed to that atmosphere, so they are known as chasmogamous flowers. Chasmogamous flowers. In this, flowers are open, opening flowers. But in some plants, flowers are not open. Flowers are not open. They are known as histogamous flower. Okay, in chasmogamous flowers, so both occur, that self-pollination and cross-pollination both occur. Not only the self-pollination, so sometimes so cross-pollination is occur depend upon that atmosphere condition. So that is known as the chasmogamous flowers. Flowers are always open. Histogamous flowers, in this flowers do not open. Okay, so they are known as the histogamous flowers. In the histogamous flowers, example, viola, common pansy, Next observe is after the comelina. In this class, okay, so flowers do not open. They are known as these two glomus flowers. For example, you take a comelina. Stimulate the rhizome. You're producing other branches, underground branches. They're having the buds, flower buds. So the reason is that comelina. So this comelina producing two types of flowers. So some flowers are present below the soil. So they do not open. Some flowers present below soil. They do not open. They are known as histogamous flowers. Histogamous flowers. Okay? So, above the flowers are known as aerial chasmogamous flowers. They are open. It means two types of flowers are present. In the histogamous flowers, the flowers do not open. At the time of mature condition, okay, so pollen grains released from the anther, they shed down on the stigma. So it is possible only for the self pollination. It is not possible to that cross pollination. It means 100% self pollination is occur in Christogamous flowers. In Christogamous flowers, 100% self pollination. There is an object to be. If pollinating agents are not available, seeds are formed. Seeds are formed. So that is known as the Christogamous flowers. Okay? That is known as orthogamy. After the greatogamy. Transfer of pollen grains from the anther reach to the stigma of the same flower. Okay? So, transfer of pollen grains from the anther. Transfer of pollen grain from anther reach to same plant. So that is known as the gaitonogamy. So in the gaitonogamy, for example, plant is single, but flowers are two. Flowers are two. For example, these are the stamen producing palm grain. For example, it is at the gynoecium part. Flowers are the different, but the plant is the same. It means flowers are different. These palm grains are released to the stigma of anther from one flower to the to reach to the stigma of another flower on same plant. So that is known as that gaitonogamy. So in this same plant, but flowers are the different. It is structurally cross pollination. But functionally self-pollination. It means it is genetically self-pollination. It means it is genetically self-pollination. It means there is no various characters are occurred in that progeny, because so plant is the same but flowers are the different. So same characters are repeated by the gaitonogamy. So it is not 100% that cross pollination. So it is also known as that genetically self pollination.